Hey guys, welcome back to Worldwide Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel, guys. If you have any of the following three vehicles, guys, Jeep Cherokee, Jeep Renegade, or Jeep Compass with a 2.4 multi air engine, guys, and you guys have a coolant leak, or you want to know where you can develop a coolant leak, stay with us, guys, and we'll explain every possible place where you can develop coolant leak on that engine. So if you have a coolant leak, you will have an idea what to look for and what to expect. With the engine being taken apart, we can show you where every little gasket is, every O-ring, so you know what to expect, guys. As you can see, that engine is out. Why? Because we guys practically have more than 100 videos probably on that engine, and we wanted to get it out of the vehicle so we can show you with great detail where everything is located, how to remove everything, how to replace pretty much any component on that engine. So make sure, guys, you subscribe to the channel. Our mission here, guys, at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. So please subscribe and like the video, guys. So let's start on it now and explain you, okay, where you can develop, guys, a coolant leak. So when you open the hood of your vehicle, guys, okay, that's what your engine will look like. You will face it this way. On the passenger side, guys, of the engine, if you come, you're going to notice on the serpentine belt here, the very last pulley, that will be the one towards the very back of the vehicle, okay, will be the pulley, guys, for the water pump. So there is, guys, actually four places where you can develop a leak, okay, from the water pump. Let's explain where. Now, when the water pump gets wore out, okay, or the seal here gets wore out, you start leaking from the shaft, okay, it will be kind of like between the pulley and the water pump, and you will notice the coolant dripping on the side of your engine. What about second place, guys? Right here we have one gasket, okay, this gasket is between the water pump and the water pump housing. Okay, that gasket, it's a metal gasket. If it goes bad, you can develop a leak, guys, right underneath it. So you'll be kind of like looking from the water pump, but maybe it will be a little bit more to the left. This is your oil pressure sensor right above it. So following this way now, guys, you have another gasket right here. This gasket is for the water pump pipe that goes to the thermostat. Okay, so right there, guys, you have one gasket again. You can develop a leak there. And the hidden gasket here is the one towards the engine block. Okay, you have a gasket on the back, so this one, guys, can be leading to an oil leak, coolant leak again, guys, right there. So hopefully it's not the case, because it's hard to remove. You have to, guys, remove the intake manifold and all that stuff. The easiest thing to do is replace the water pump. We have the video on the channel how to do that. Not very complicated at all. Now we come towards the side, and right next to the transmission, guys, on the driver's side is your thermostat right here. This is your thermostat. Okay, we're missing now one bolt. We're putting it together. Okay, I wanted to show you a few things. Here now, guys, you have two hoses. These holes here and the hose right there. Those are for the heater core. Okay, those two hoses. So check for leaks, guys. Okay, these hoses, they have inside. Okay, let me focus here quick. Inside there is a seal as well, O-rings, so if they get wore out, they start leaking. You can, guys, develop a leak from your temperature sensor, coolant temperature sensor, if it's not installed, not tight enough. You can develop a leak that's a weak spot, guys. This is coming from the coolant overflow bottle, coolant tank, and here those pipes, okay, it's a plastic pipe, it cracks often, so you can develop the leak right here very easy. And that's the thermostat housing gasket, okay, it's an O-ring. So that one there, guys, if it gets old, I've seen that one develop quite a few water leaks, excuse me. So if I said somewhere oil leak, I meant water leak, coolant leak. So here, past the thermostat, you have these three hoses. Check your hoses and everything, guys, but usually here you will not develop a leak. This is going to the radiator. This is the radiator top hose. If it's on the front side of the vehicle, then you either have a leaking hose or you have a bad radiator, guys. Okay, so check that. Now, what else, guys? Right here you have another. This is the bottom radiator hose, and this one has O-ring inside of it. Rubber O-ring. This one is known, okay, to get really hard over time and develop a leak. So if you have a leak from the front passenger side of the radiator, check that one. And here you have two hoses that go to the oil core. Make sure that they're installed correctly, that they're not cracked or melted from the heat, because sometimes they will, guys, crack from that heat, especially if you're exposed, somebody didn't install them correctly, anything like that, guys. So those are the potential places where you can develop a leak, and the radiator, of course, itself, or the radiator then drain plug. So thank you for watching, guys. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos, and see you guys next time.